Hey there, it's Hesu, and right now we're going to be talking about personal boundaries. So first, when you hear that word boundary, what do you think of? The first thing that comes to mind, in fact, for me, is sports. We're thinking of the players, the action, the ball, whatever it is. It's being contained in the boundaries of a field, a court, an arena, whatever it is. And the idea is to contain space, to keep people somewhere, right? So now we're jumping into personal boundaries. What are they? For me, they're the emotional limits, the actual physical barriers or mental blocks that we put into place to protect ourselves from getting used, manipulated, hurt, or bothered by other people. So why are personal boundaries important? If you find yourself being the pushover or someone that people step all over and constantly use for this and this and that, you might benefit from thinking about and establishing more personal boundaries in your life. So how do we do this? We're gonna explore this a little bit, talk about why it's useful. Let's talk about self-concept. This is the way that you view yourself. When you are able to establish healthy personal boundaries with people, you're communicating to them that you respect yourself, that you have integrity, and that you value your time, right? And you want others to value their time with you too. So what are some of the things that might make it challenging to set personal boundaries? We all have a hard time saying no sometimes, and saying no is often one of the biggest things we can do to set a boundary with somebody. Why is it so hard to say no sometimes? I think in our culture, in our society, we're all raised and socialized to accommodate other people. We're often thinking of other people's needs and feelings, and sometimes we even prioritize those things before our own. But I would really like for you to remember that your feelings, your needs, these things are incredibly important for your overall wellness and satisfaction in life. So some things to remember is you are not responsible for somebody else's happiness. However, you can be responsible for the way that you allow other people to treat you. So thinking about what it is that makes it hard to say no kind of brings up feelings of guilt or feeling somehow obligated to make sure this other person feels good. And sometimes we're even scared of how we might feel knowing that we made this other person feel uncomfortable or sad or whatever it is because we said no. However, I would really encourage you to get in the habit of saying no to people in order to protect yourself, your time, and your self-concept and how you perceive yourself and self-worth. So a tip I have for you is to get to know yourself. What I mean by that, a lot of people can do this through counseling or just meditation or finding some kind of activity out there in our big, beautiful world to get to know what your values are, get really firm in your stance on big things in this world. Like I said, you want to find out what you're okay with, what you're not okay with, because this will help you identify when you feel like you're not being treated right or someone is stepping all over you. If you find that you're often going against your own values or your beliefs to accommodate the feelings and needs of other people, or if you find that your actions and your words aren't matching all the time and that makes you feel bad, it could really benefit you to start thinking about personal boundaries and how to start setting them in your life. If you like this video, please feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel where you'll find a lot more content on a variety of mental health topics. And if you're interested in learning more about online counseling, please click the link to betterhelp.com below.